Hey there, and welcome to the Jim Bob Drawing Show, where we draw cartoons and art just for fun. My name is Bobby Chu.
And I'm Jim Bryson.
All right, Jim, so let's see what the topic is for this week. So we got magical
robot.
So I thought, like, you know, what would make a robot magical? Because they're not alive, right? So I thought for a robot to be magic, it would have to transcend all the machines and somehow create life or create something organic, living. And so out of all these robots, there was one robot that could somehow take the things we take for granted, like a little plant. And in the future, if everything gets bulldozed and there's no longer trees or plants or anything, then they would be very special in this artificial world.
Cool. I wasn't too sure what the overall story was, but I really liked it. It's kind of like The Last Survivor, and it happens to be a magical robot holding a magical flower. That's what I was kind of thinking.
It's a tough one to come up with, because it's like, how do you get across a magical robot?
I was surprised that you put in that noun, you know, of robot, because we both don't like drawing robots.
Yeah, I mean, I was like, when I was thinking of the different nouns, I was like, I don't really want to draw a robot, but I think it's probably good to try it, just as a challenge, I guess.
It looks like it took you quite a long time, and there is a lot of intricate rendering there, shading there. It was really neat to see, and something that some of the more beginner viewers might not know is the whole entire purpose of why you had the paper there under your hand.
To prevent smudging.
Yes, to prevent smudging, which I thought could be worth mentioning, right?
Yeah.
I'm gonna bring this lovely drawing into my Photoshop. When I was looking at the drawing, I was thinking about the lighting scheme, right? So you have the sky, you have the clouds. The sky, the clouds, they are generally bright things. So I was mindful of that as I was painting the background. And then you drew about 50,000 robots, so I thought, it might be good to mask all these, you know, make a selection.
It's too bad they haven't come up with some sort of automation for masking out large areas.
True. Well, you know, if they have a function for everything, then we're out of a job, aren't we, Jimmy?
It's true.
So the other thing I was thinking about, what's going to take me way longer, is all the different elements, because there's all these different robots and they're made of all these different parts. So what color is this going to be? What color is that going to be? As I was painting all these colorful cones in there, I started thinking robots, metal, they're generally all going to be kind of gray, so maybe I will leave most of it gray with accents of color, and that'll actually work.
Yeah, it looks cool.
Nice bright light, and I made the base tone of the robot white so that we will be able to see it a lot more. It is the last survivor amongst all of these deceased robots. And that's pretty much it. So I hope you like the video. I hope you like the drawing as well as the painting. And if you like to draw, I highly recommend you follow us on Instagram at Jim Bob Drawing Show. You'll get a prompt every week, then you can draw along with us before we actually show you our version. Not only that, but we will show you our favorites from other people on Instagram, so you can hashtag us, Jim Bob Drawing Show. And then don't forget to subscribe to our channel on YouTube, and then press the
notification button.
That way you'll get instant notification the next time we put up a new video. See you guys next week.
See ya.